More than 50 years have passed since humans last walked on the moon. The Apollo missions captivated the world. And now NASA are preparing a new mission, ready to inspire a new generation.
Please join us for Reed Weissman, Victor Glover, Christina Cook and Jeremy Hansen. Can you please join us on the stage here today? It's the Artemis II.
Good afternoon on the moon. Awesome, I love it. Thank you so much.
So, should we begin with the first question?
Thank you for that question. It's a great one. And the shuttle was a very special spaceship because it actually went to space like a rocket, but then landed like an airplane. And when that mission was done, we actually retired that spaceship called the shuttle, and we started flying to space with our international partners, Russians on a Russian spaceship called the Soyuz. So that's why we decided to stop flying the shuttle in 2011.
Have you ever been to space, and what does it feel like?
I've been to space one time, for 168 days, and it was fun and amazing and new, but it was also busy and challenging. And to see our home planet, the Earth, from 260 miles above the surface is just breathtaking.
That answer is easy. 100% yes. Not only just a yes, we actually need you to come work with us to send humans to the moon and to Mars, because you will bring a different perspective and you will bring different knowledge that will help us solve problems in a way that the four of us couldn't think to solve these problems.
What is it like to eat, drink, and go to the toilet in space?
Excellent question.
I guess it's almost always funny. Eating is funny, going to the bathroom is funny, so I'll try to be brief, but all of the food that we eat is shipped up to the International Space Station by teams on the ground to prepare this food for us, and it all comes in little bags. So you just have to warm it up, you open up the package, and then you eat it. So we actually urinate into a funnel that gets sucked down into a reclamation system, and our urine gets converted back into drinking water while we're on the space station, which sounds disgusting, but it's actually amazing that we can recycle all of our byproducts up there and reuse them, and we have almost a self-contained environment. And then for number two in space, I'm not even gonna go into it, it's just always humorous, but we have a good system that kind of draws waste away from the human body, and then we put it into little containers, and when the containers get full, we put them in the trash, and we burn them up in the atmosphere.
Amazing question, I love that one, that's brilliant. So how do you answer this?
Well, I personally think that sleeping in space is the best sleep you can possibly have. It is so peaceful and so comfortable. We have to sleep inside of a sleeping bag that's attached to the wall so that we don't float away. When you try to lay down on something in space, it doesn't work. You just float right up. So that's why we use special space sleeping bags with a hole for your arms. And you kind of sleep like this.
Thank you so much for talking to the children today and for answering these questions. Everyone, give a round of applause.